Outside of the helix coils, we have our microfibrils. The hair continues to twist around itself, and it makes macrofibrils. And then our macrofibrils turn into fibrils that live under the cortical cell. So the reason that that's expanded is because when we look at someone's hair strand, we can't see that with our natural eye. So we would need a microscope to see that. So that's some smart stuff, right? You guys are like brain guys. So a lot of times when we talk about the things we just talked about, as hairstylists, we really focus on those three things, the cuticle, the medulla, and the cortex, right? If we have a basic understanding of these three parts, we can be an okay hairstylist. But some of you guys may want to go into the theory part of hairstyling. Maybe you want to get into product development, or maybe you want to create your own shampoo or your own product line. You would have to spend a little bit more time becoming a trichologist and really getting down into the nitty-gritty study of the hair. So we don't need to know all of that stuff to be a successful hairstylist, but if you decide to go